In some cases, your fingerprint, TCPOS fingerprint, should match to your user agent, for example. If you're like pretending to be a Mac user or iOS user or Windows user, your TCP fingerprint should be matched with your browser fingerprint, right?
Hey, what's up? This is Stan. We are here at Affiliate World Barcelona, and I'm here with Sabir, the co-founder of iProxy.online. Really nice to meet you. Nice to see you. So iProxy.online is a service where you can create your own proxy using an Android device. Is that correct?
Yeah, this is correct. Yeah.
Cool. So how does it actually work? Like, how can anybody use iProxy to iProxy.online to set up their own proxy?
Yeah. So first of all, let me just say a couple of words about mobile proxies, why everybody needs that. The thing is that mobile IP addresses are precious because, for instance, you have Barcelona, we are here in Barcelona, and you have like 2 million people living there, and you have like several thousands of IP addresses from your mobile providers. And one IP address is shared by many, through thousands of people, right? And if you have mobile IP address, this cannot be blocked by Facebook or Instagram or any other services, because in this case, like innocent people, like thousands of them will be blocked. So, and mobile proxies are very good in such cases as running ads, farming accounts, scraping, and so on. And well, actually, this is quite an expensive thing, because you need to have like 3G modems, you need to have like equipment for that, and so on. It requires some skills, technical.
If you want your own proxy.
Yeah, yeah. So, and of course, you can buy it. Lots of providers, they sell it. It's pretty expensive, by the way, and depends on the gear. And yeah, as you asked about iProxy, how we help, how we make it affordable. So, you know, everyone can buy a used Android device, and you can install iProxy app here. And you in the dashboard, you have proxy access, like SOX 5, HTTP accesses, and traffic goes through your device.
Cool, so I just like get a mobile device, install iProxy, and I ultimately get a proxy that I can put into multi-login, a browser.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, this is just a regular proxy, but it has mobile IP address. Mobile IP address is just coming from the SIM card that is installed here.
Yeah.
And basically, your expenses are like you pay like for the SIM card, you pay a small subscription fee to the service, and you just it's it. That requires like 1 minute of work just to download an app.
I totally agree with you regarding mobile IPs. Like, as you said, they have this technology called NAT technology, and because IPv4 IP addresses are so limited in quantity, right now we are sitting and our both mobile phones, it is very likely that both of our mobile phones will have the same IP address.
Yeah, exactly.
And imagine like somebody is using it for Facebook, but somebody is using it for normal activities. And that's why Facebook and Google will not ban this.
Exactly. And you know, there are different types of proxies, like residential proxies, data center proxies, and mobile proxies. So how mobile proxies are different? The thing is that if you have like server proxy, this has just one IP.
Yes.
And many users, they share this IP. You don't know what this user is doing, right?
Yes.
They may be doing some farming and so on, and you may be banned because someone was doing something. And you
with that IP address.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. But having a mobile IP address, you don't have such an issue. And moreover, you can change IP remotely. By the way, if you switch airplane mode, turn it on and turn it off, you will get a new IP address. So,
can you like refresh the IP address using iProxy?
Yeah, of course. We offer like changing IP by schedule, like every minute, every 5 minutes, like regularly. Or you can click on the button, or you can have a link or API, or you can use Telegram bot. So any options?
Telegram bot.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, this is very popular because,
for
instance, if your proxy is not running, you get instant notification. Or if you change IP, you get like a new IP address notification in your Telegram. This is very useful because typically these phones, they can be in different locations, and you need to know if they're working and if you need to, you know, fix something and so on. And moreover, sometimes in different countries, you need to have specific time in airplane mode to change your IP. And we have in the iProxy there are lots of settings, so you can just adjust it for any use case. Like for instance, you need your IP address to be unique for 5 hours. You can like set in iProxy this time range, and this will change IP like airplane mode until you get this unique IP. And one important thing that is kind of coming up nowadays is TCPOS fingerprint.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The thing is that proxy providers, they offer you like Linux TCP fingerprint, and in some cases your fingerprint, TCPOS fingerprint, should match to your user agent, for example. If you're like pretending to be a Mac user or iOS user or Windows user, your TCP fingerprint should be matched with your browser fingerprint, right? And this is something that iProxy does as well.
Oh, cool.
Control it, you can just set in your personal account or your API or whatever.
But how is it really important to have the TCP IP fingerprint matching the operating system inside the browser profile? How important it is?
Well, you know, in some cases, this is less important than the other, in the other cases. So in farming, this is becoming more and more important nowadays, because this is the additional kind of flag that your TCPOS fingerprint is not matching to your actually browser fingerprint.
So it can actually give an additional boost or additional stability of your
exactly.
account.
So, you know, in the multi-login, you have lots of tools that help to pretend like...
Make more consistent.
Yeah, be more consistent. And proxy is just one of the thing in the list you should be aware of and take into account, actually.
That's really cool, because on the multi-login level, we are not able to change TCP IP.
Yeah.
And actually also many proxy providers, they simply do not provide this TCP IP masking. What I would like to also ask you, why would anybody want to even think about creating their own proxy, let's say, hub or a proxy farm, and ditch their existing proxy provider? Why would they wanna start using their own proxy farm? What would be the underlying reason?
Yeah, actually, one of the reasons why you should probably should have your own proxy farm is that you 100% sure that only you using them, right?
True.
Even if someone sells you private mobile proxies, they say this, but they can sell this exact proxy to anyone, right?
Yeah.
So it is a matter of trust, but having your own proxy farm is like guarantees you that nobody is using that, right? The other thing is that you may use different proxy providers, and there is a tool, it's called iProxy Tools.
Yeah.
Easy to remember, like tools. Yeah, and actually, if you have already some providers, so if you have like residential proxies or data center proxies, you want to monitor them just to be sure that they are online. You just want to have a history of IP addresses or like get notifications if something goes wrong. You can use this tool. Of course, you can use iProxy proxies, but not only these proxies. You can monitor these like other types of proxies with iProxy.tools.
This is very interesting. So you can basically monitor your different proxies and check whether they're up and down, right?
Yeah, actually, this is exactly.
I know proxies go down all the time.
It's becoming annoying. You don't know when it happened, but if you get instant notification, if you can just open up a page and see what was the exact time and so on, you can prevent this and so on.
I know that some of users, when they click start, to start the browser profile, it's also sometimes not working. And when we go ahead and check, it's actually the proxy's fault. So that'll be very useful, I think, yeah.
Yeah, actually, proxy checker. And also there is a very nice thing there is that, for instance, you have like a pool of 10 proxies, and you may create, it's called cluster. So you may create like additional proxy, which connects to this, one of these 10 proxies, let's say, right?
Cool. Uh-huh.
And so this is how you can get the instant IP change. Because your first request goes to the first proxy, second request goes to the second proxy, and at the same time, you may change the IP of the first proxy. So this is how, it's similar to how the cars are working, right?
It's like a CRM system for proxies.
Yeah, exactly. So it's a tool. Everyone is using proxies, but there are some pains when you use that. And we just, iProxy Online, iProxy Tools, just trying to help users to have less pain,
Do I understand correctly that when you have a couple of mobile IPs, mobile phones can in one specific location, they are limited to a certain IP range. How would one want to get another IP range? Would they have to station their Android phones in a different location?
Yeah, actually, good question. You know, for instance, we are here like in a specific location. Imagine we have like one phone working like for like weeks or months and so on. And the thing is that you get your actual network from the nearest 3G or 5G or 4G point. And it has the pool, like let's say the specific number of IP addresses. So if you just move to another location, right, there will be a different point, right?
Cool. Mm-hmm.
And there is a different range of IP addresses. So actually, kind of affiliates, they have like phones in different locations. They have their phones distributed. And and by the way, some of the users, they use it for their own needs, but also you can earn on that. If you just, have a possibility to get some SIM cards, some cheap phones, you can actually resell it. You just install the this app, you can make your website, you can advertise, and you can earn money, even if you are not affiliate and so on.
Really, really cool.
So, yeah.
Do you also help to set up, because we are currently talking about individual phones, can you also help set up different proxy farms, like full sets of mobile phones?
Yeah, actually, we have a very nice support. And if you have any questions, we can help you with different models. We have
device selection.
We have the list of kind of devices that we recommend. And any questions that if you have with setting up these things, there is a way for solving that. And like people in 70 countries already saving lots of money. Because instead of paying like 10x to someone and you don't know if this is used by anybody else, you can actually get your physical phone. You can just ask your friends just to install it to get SIM card, and that's it. You have your own private proxies, and it's affordable.
Sabir, this is very useful and interesting information. Thanks very much for sharing.
Thank you very much for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you here.